straight to right.
Preach by 2212 Elliott S22. Hold the mic 1222 Elliott S. Hold the mic 1 2.
Thank you.
Welcome on Advent Sunday to this service of Choral Evensong. It's my great privilege and pleasure on your behalf to welcome as our guest preacher tonight, Father Paul Elliott, who is the Rector of the Russian Orthodox Church of St. Elisabeth, the New-Martyr. We're very much looking forward to that which you're going to be saying to us, Father, later on in the service. Just to note that there will be a retiring collection this evening, and there are refreshments in the dining hall after this service. We turn now to page 9 in the Green Chapel service books. Beloved, we are come together in the presence of Almighty God and of the whole company of heaven to offer unto him through our Lord Jesus Christ our worship and praise and thanksgiving, to make confession of our sins, to pray as well for others as for ourselves, that we may know more truly the greatness of God's love and show forth in our lives the fruits of his grace, and to ask on behalf of all people such things as their well-being doth require. Wherefore, let us kneel in silence and remember God's presence with us now. And merciful Lord, grant unto you pardon and remission of all your sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The choir will sing, and we'll be seated but standing for the Gloria.
Dear Lord, show us your The first lesson is taken from 1 Corinthians 1, verses 3 to 9. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I always thank my God for you because of his grace given you in Christ Jesus. For in him you have been enriched in every way, with all kinds of speech and with all knowledge. God thus confirming our testimony about Christ among you. Therefore, you do not lack any spiritual gift as you eagerly await for our Lord Jesus Christ to be revealed. He will also keep you firm to the end, so that you will be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, who has called you into fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Thank you. The second lesson is taken from the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 13, verses 24 to 37. But in those days following that distress, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from the sky, and the heavenly bodies will be shaken. At that time, people will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. And he will send his angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of the heavens. Now learn this lesson from the fig tree. As soon as its twigs get tender and its leaves come out, you know that summer is near. Even so, when you see these things happening, you know that it is near, right at the door. Truly, I tell you, this generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Be on guard, be alert. You do not know when that time will come. It's like a man going away. He leaves his house and puts his servants in charge, each with their assigned task, and tells the one at the door to keep watch. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know when the owner of the house will come back, whether in the evening or at midnight, or when the rooster crows or at dawn. If he comes suddenly, do not let him find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to everyone, watch. Here ends the second lesson.
Lord, how matters now thy soul.
was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Seated now as the choir sing the anthem, the Herefordshire Carol, words set to music by Ralph Vaughan Williams.
News is the true sense. Now to sing hymn number 3.
Like a microphone, no idea. But I probably don't need it. Do sit down. Whenever I come here, I tell you how blessed you are to have such a tradition as you have. For the tradition that you have has disappeared in many parts of our country, but is still alive and well here. And one of the good things about this tradition is that it enables you to keep Advent properly, because Advent has almost disappeared, because in Merseyside, they tell me, they put up their deckies very, very early to make the most of it. They kind of forget that there is a preparation period for Advent. It is actually a very important period. You probably don't know my past. My past, I was an Anglican clergyman in this diocese, in the Beretta belt of Crewe, and at St. Michael's Coppenhall. And we started Advent Sunday with a solemn procession, right round a figure eight procession, with a thurifer at the front. A thurifer is somebody who carries the incense. We were dressed ready for the solemn high mass, and we processed round in a figure eight procession. And by the end of the figure eight procession, that is right round the church in a figure eight, you couldn't see from one end of St. Michael's Coppenhall to the other for incense. It was one of those occasions where you needed either a full high mass set to wear it or a gas mask. I was never sure which was the best to wear. But Advent Sunday was opened with great solemnity. And we did the Asperges May. That is, we blessed the whole congregation with holy water before we sang the solemn High Mass. It was a very amazing and dignified occasion, and was such a spectacle that people used to come, especially for Advent Sunday, because St. Michael's, in those days, it was quite a spectacle to see such a thing. And of course, you have why it is so special. And you have that in the collect for today. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armor of light. This is the first part of the collect for Advent Sunday from the Book of Common Prayer. In the Orthodox Church to which I belong, we actually have a fast before Christmas. We go without certain foods. We don't eat meat. We don't eat eggs. We don't have milk. We do have a little bit of fish at weekends, and we avoid luxuries of any kind. Now, this isn't just to punish Orthodox people. This is to help us to prepare for Christmas and to make ourselves ready to receive the Holy Christ child. And if you like, to be the manger that the Holy Mother of God, the Blessed Virgin Mary, lays the Christ child into. This fasting helps us to put away the works of darkness and to cleanse our consciences and to try, albeit for a brief season, to step away from selfishness and from greed. Of course, you will have long ago done your Christmas lists. That's what young people do now, and they send them by WhatsApp to their parents. And you'll be dreaming of all the things that you might receive at Christmas. New bikes, the latest phone, new designer clothes, and all those things that occupy the minds of young people today. But this time should not really be a time where we're looking forward to all these material things. Rather, it should be a different time that is set apart to looking forward to some other things. Looking forward to the restoration inside us of the qualities that are necessary for a good and a holy life. Asking God to send to us a spirit of kindness, a spirit of generosity, and a spirit of love. Making ourselves aware that these qualities are indeed the armor of light, and that these qualities are the only qualities that can overcome the powers of darkness. So often, we are very blind to what is important. We're blinded by so many material things. But Advent is a time when Christian people should reflect upon the fact that all these shiny material things that we crave will just pass away. And they will be as nothing. But the qualities of gentleness, kindness, generosity, and love are actually the greatest treasures that we can crave. We are, most of us, very fortunate. There's a man in St. Luke's Gospel in one of the parables of the Savior, and he crams more and more grain into ever larger storehouses, and he doesn't share any. In fact, the more grain he has, the larger he hopes to build his storehouses. He doesn't care for the poor. He doesn't care for the hungry. He's blind to the needs of others. But in this parable, you hear the somewhat scary voice of God. "Thou fool," he says, "this night thy soul shall be required of thee." St. Paul says that we bring nothing into this world. And he also says that it is certain that we can take nothing out, well, not material things. We can take with us the eternal qualities, the eternal virtues that we try to develop in this mortal life. And we can avoid emulating the lives of those who are greedy, those who are harsh, those who are selfish, and those who are cruel. And we should try to copy and emulate the lives of the saints who shine with eternal glory. So be very, very careful about what role models and what influences you seek out at this time to copy and emulate. So often we copy the wrong people. We emulate the wrong qualities. We take notice of exactly the wrong people. We remember that St. Paul tells us to search out that which is true, that which is faithful, that which is lovely, that which is of good report. We should search out those who are selfless, those who are loving and generous and kind, and try to live like they do. Those are the sort of people we should try to copy, and those are the sort of people we should try to be like, so that other people will copy us and try to live in that way. We should try to live this way so that we can prepare ourselves to be the dwelling place of God the Word, to be the manger that the Mother of God lays her defenseless child into. So by Christmas, we're not preoccupied with material things. We are more preoccupied by spiritual things. And so, as we meditate on Advent Sunday, let us pray that it's our hearts that rejoice in wanting Christ our Saviour to reside within us, a longing, a hope, a faith that we can change and Christ can change us as he comes to dwell within us on Christmas Day. May God bless us and keep us, may the light of his countenance shine upon us and be merciful unto us. Amen.
So as we come to the end of this Advent Sunday service, let us ask God's blessing upon us as we travel now in this holy season. So the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you and remain with you this Advent and always. Amen. Amen. We sing now as our recessional hymn, hymn number 7.